Guatemala has said it is withdrawing from a United Nations-backed anti-corruption commission, which has been investigating the country's president Jimmy Morales. Guatemalan Foreign Minister Sandra Jovo said on Monday that the United Nations body had 24 hours to leave the country. She said Mr. Morales would continue the fight against the corruption, but that there had been a misunderstanding about the investigations into his affairs. Elected 3 years ago, Mr. Morales initially supported the United Nations Commission, the mandate of the International Commission Against Impunity in Guatemala, CICIG, has helped prosecutors bring cases against dozens of senior officials and executives. However, when Mr. Morales became the subject of its investigations, the president said he would review its mandate. His comments were criticized and led to street protests against official corruption and demonstrations demanding his resignation. During a meeting with the United Nations Secretary General Antonio Guterres on Monday, Ms. Jovo announced that the CICIG mandate, a body created in 2006 and designed to strengthen the country's rule of law, would be ending. Mr. Guterres responded in a statement, saying that he strongly rejects the decision, adding that the government must abide by the international deal. The CICIG had sought to prosecute Mr. Morales, who was a comedian before becoming president in 2016, over allegations of funding irregularities linked to his 2015 election campaign. The United Nations backed calls for the removal of Mr. Morales' immunity in order to allow him to be investigated. That move followed separate CICIG investigations into members of the president's family. A popular tourist attraction has become the latest Chinese company to show solidarity with Huawei's chief finance officer, Meng Wanzhou, who was arrested in Canada on 1 December. Shannon Mountain Scenic Park in eastern Hainan province said it would waive the $9.65 ticket fee for anyone carrying a Huawei phone. Ms. Meng, who was given bail in Canada, faces extradition to the United States on charges of breaking Iran sanctions. Her case has upped tensions with China. U.S. Huawei phones should grant photos on the mountain, a notice on the Shannon Park's social media account said. We wish friends around the world who support Huawei success in bliss. The offer would last until 29 December, the South China Morning Post reported, but it was met with some criticism among China's social media users, who claimed it was discriminatory. Huawei phone owners are being offered other enticements too. They can get a 20% discount at a bar in Beijing. Seen in Beijing, bring a Huawei phone and get 20% off. Similar to this story we covered yesterday, https://co.qxl1iypqlpic, twitter.com/sokolov, end of Twitter post by @loshinj. At least one firm has threatened to penalize anyone buying Apple products. A few days ago, Manpada Shenzhen, based LED display manufacturer, offered subsidies to any employees buying Huawei phones. It also pledged to fine anyone who bought an Apple iPhone. United States prosecutors alleged Ms. Meng,
46,
used a Huawei subsidiary called Skycom to evade sanctions on Iran. Between 2009 and 2014, they also allege she publicly misrepresented Skycom as being a separate company from Huawei, and that she deceived banks about the true relationship between the two companies. Ms. Meng, who is the daughter of Huawei's founder, has denied any wrongdoing and said she will contest the allegations. Life of Huawei's high-flying heiress. The United States has been investigating the Chinese telecoms giant, the world's second-largest smartphone maker, since 2016, believing that it used Skycom to bring the United States manufacturing equipment and millions of dollars in transactions to Iran in violation of sanctions. Ms. Meng's detention comes amid an increasingly acrimonious trade dispute between Washington and Beijing. China is angry at her detention, saying she has not violated any laws. Beijing has threatened severe consequences unless Canada releases the executive. Since her arrest, two Canadians, a former diplomat and a businessman, have been detained in China on suspicion of harming national security. United States President Donald Trump said last week that he might intervene in the United States Justice Department's case against Ms. Meng if it would serve national security interests or help achieve a trade deal with China. If I think it's good for what will be certainly the largest trade deal ever made, which is a very important thing. What's good for national security? I would certainly intervene if I thought it was necessary, he told Reuters news agency. Canada reacted by urging Mr. Trump not to politicize the situation. Our extradition partners should not seek to politicize the extradition process or use it for ends other than the pursuit of justice, Foreign Minister Chrystia Freeland said. Two Scandinavian women tourists have been found dead in Morocco, with kids to their necks, the country's interior ministry said. Both bodies were found near the town of Inlia in the High Atlas mountain range, near the foot of North Africa's highest peak, Mount Zabka. The women, from Denmark and Norway respectively, have not yet been named. A police investigation has been launched into their deaths, the Interior Ministry statement said. The United States military says it has killed 62 fighters from the Islamist group Al-Shabaab in 6 airstrikes in Somalia. 4 airstrikes on Saturday killed 32 militants, and a further 2 on Sunday killed 28, it said in a statement. These were the deadliest air attacks in Somalia since November 2017, when the United States said it had killed 100 militants. Somalia has seen a sharp increase in the number of airstrikes and casualties since President Donald Trump took office in the United States in January 2017. A tally by the Bureau of Investigative Journalism reveals that at least 400 people have been killed in airstrikes since the beginning of 2017, far more than the previous 10 years combined. The latest strikes bring to at least 30 the number carried out in Somalia so far this year, compared with 35 recorded in 2017. The United States has a huge military base in neighboring Djibouti, from where it launches attacks on the militants. Mr. Trump gave the United States military greater authority in March 2017 to attack militants in Somalia. Traditionally, United States presidents have been wary of intervening in Somalia since 18 special forces soldiers died fighting militias in the capital Mogadishu in 1993, a battle dramatized in the film Black Hawk Down, No civilians were killed in the latest airstrikes, which were carried out in coordination with the Somali government, the United States military said. Alongside our Somali and international partners, we are committed to preventing Al-Shabaab from taking advantage of safe havens from which they can build capacity and attack the people of Somalia, the United States Africa Command said. Al-Shabaab, which is linked to Al-Qaeda, has not yet commented on the latest strikes. Somalia-based security think tank the High Wall Institute said in a report published in November that Al-Shabaab had been forced to change tactics following the upsurge in airstrikes. The institute said the group was now conducting fewer mass attacks on military bases, but attacks on government offices and businesses which refused to pay its taxes had increased markedly. The United States State Department, in its most recent report on terrorism,